Okay, so today I'm going to show you how to repair the rear latch, the rear hatch latch, on a first-gen Sequoia. I guess a lot of people have had problems with these over the years. The rear hatch won't open, and a lot of people end up breaking the handle. And it's not usually the handle's fault, it's the latch. So there's actually a design flaw that I feel like built into the latch, and there's a simple fix for it, and I'm going to show you how to do it today. And I'm going to actually start off as if your rear door will not open, and I'll show you exactly what to do step by step on how to fix it. And I had the same problem on mine. I think I went through two or three latches before I figured out this little issue. And I'd replace the latch, and usually within a week to a month, the new latch would fail and the rear door wouldn't open. And I tend to notice it more the colder it was outside. So, but anyway, I'm going to dig into this, and I'll show you what to do. First off, I want to apologize if there's any crazy sound. I've got my heater going out here. It's pretty cold. So, just to show you that mine does work for now. There it goes. Works just fine, but we're gonna pretend that it does not. So first off, roll the back window down. Okay. Then you wanna start off taking the center piece of trim off. Usually you can just kind of get your fingers up under it. See? Just peel away, and off she comes. Do the same for the sides. Okay. All right. The next step is you just take out this one single bolt right here. It has a 10 millimeter head on it. It's the only bolt that you'll see on the outside right here. Okay, so the next step you're gonna do is have to remove this. It can be kind of a turd to get off of here, but I'll show you how. You can see the whole side, right, or the whole hatch cover, whatever you want to call this. You end up having to get over here in the corner and just try to lift up. Get your finger down in here, try to lift up. See, it'll start coming right off. And off she comes. Let's get this out of here. And that will expose everything that you want to get to. All right. Okay. So the next thing you want to do is get this black access panel off. And there's a panel right here on the end that you want to get off of there too. And they all have, they're held on with little 10 millimeter head bolts. They're almost just like a sheet metal screw. And take them off. Let's see. Helps if you keep everything a little magnetic tray so you don't lose nothing. Okay. And once you get those out of there, you'll notice that there's all these little white clips. There's what, three of them. And then it don't really matter. You just grab this and just pull it off. See? Just comes right off. What's gonna suck is you have to leave this kind of plugged in because there's a harness right here. You can unplug it right here, but that's not gonna matter because you still have the harness right here that goes inside, and it's a huge pain in the butt to have to go through and unplug and mess with it. So just leave this panel on here. And you come over to this one. This panel right here, same thing. Just peels right off. Set her out of the way. No big deal. All right, next step. Roll up the back window. You can either use the key or you can use the switch that's obviously up on your dash just to the left of the steering wheel. Something I want to add, if you're having the issue that I've had before where the actual latch is having an issue unlocking, what you can do, and I've had to do in the past, and it really helps, is you actually just start the vehicle up. And then I think with just the added voltage of the engine running, because you know your normal battery voltage is about 12 volts, and now that's running, it's probably at about 14 and a half. Just those two extra volts really helps to help unjam it. But if you sit here, if you keep hitting the lock, see, it'll force it to unlock. And if you do this enough times, and you may have to have somebody standing at the back yanking on the handle, usually it'll eventually unlock on its own. It also helps if you pull the vehicle into a garage where it's warmer, because I've noticed that these latches tend to fail more often whenever it is cold outside. So if you can pull it into a garage, get it somewhat warmed up, it tends to break loose a lot easier. So I've had to do that before, and that's like the only way I know of to actually get this thing to unlock. Okay, so this next thing, if this is for those people that actually have a broken handle, the only way that you can get this thing to actually release, if you can get the door to unlock, is, see if I can't zoom in here a little bit better. There it is. So if you can see, let's get my hand up in here. See this cable right here? Here's the cable in. The actual cable ball is right behind here where my finger is. You've got to be able to get some pliers or something. You can get your fingers if you're strong enough. But get up in here, grab a hold of it. It's a little hard to do. Then pull. Push on the door, and it is now open. Get my lights out of here. All right. Now the door will open. Watch this panel. There it goes. Now you've gotten that far, the door is open. And what I actually used to do that is these curved pliers, these curved needle nose pliers. You can have some that are curved like this or curved straight down. Doesn't really matter. Any kind of needle nose pliers will probably help quite a bit. So that's how you can get, once you get the panel off and everything, that's how you can grab the cable and actually get the door open. Okay, so the next thing that you're going to want to do is we're going to take this little black cover off right here. I'll show you how to do that. It is the cover for the latch assembly. You see, it just pops right off. If you notice, it's got these two little tabs right here. So whenever you go to put this sucker back on, it'll just line up right here
You just pop it right back on. It's pretty easy. So we're going to take that off. And it has three bolts in it with a little 10 millimeter head on them. Okay. And you just push it in.
In case you're wondering why I decided to pull this one little panel off, it's not totally necessary. The only reason I do it is just to be able to get a flashlight in there, and you can still get your hand up in here if you need to without any kind of real interference. So, but anyway, the next step, what you want to do, see this little clip right here? You want to take a screwdriver, a little mini screwdriver or something, and you want to pry it open. Let's see if I can't get that. There it goes. And you want it'll get that out. Then you want to come over to the actual latch assembly. And can. It might be a little hard to do this one-handed, but I'll try. There's a little plug right here that you want to undo. So let me try to get the motor out, or I'm sorry, get the actuator out, and I'll see if I can't show you a little bit better. I also need to add that there is this little clip right here that holds the harness in for that plug, and it really helps if you can take a little screwdriver or pliers or whatever. Push the little side tabs in, little locking tabs, push them in, yep, see, there it goes. It'll make it a lot easier to get this out and maneuver it around where you can get that plug undone. Okay, so once you get the little holding clip out right here, you can get the slit out of here. Trying to. And it'll have two electrical connectors. And the first one is right here. Squeeze the little tab, pull it out. And then let's see here. The second one, right here, same thing. Squeeze the tab. Pull it out, disconnect it, and it'll drop down. You can have all the access that you need right here. So, you're gonna want to pull this little rubber plug out right here. It's I don't know, it's like a little dust cover, I guess. Just pull that out, set it off to the side, and then let's see here. Okay, now that we have the whole latch assembly out of the rear door here, to get this plastic cover off, to gain access to everything, you're going to want to get these two little screws out, and that will get your plastic cover off. Okay, so once you get the two little screws out of here, that's the only two screws that hold this on. You're going to want to take this, and you can see where the cable sits in the housing right here. Just kind of pop this sucker off. Let's see. See, there it goes. And if I remember correctly, you also have to take this little lock tab right here. Once again, push the pins in on it. Pop that little lock tab out. And then you just kind of work it off of here. See? And that'll expose the whole latch assembly. So, okay. Okay, so here's where the little trick that you can do to get your actuator to work probably forever. You don't even have to take the cable off. You can if you want. It's no big deal. If you want to, you would just have to pop it off right here and pop the little cable ball out of this right here, but I'm not going to take that out. So what I ended up having to do is, see if I can't zoom in on this a little bit. Okay. So if you look right here, this little pin is what gets stuck. So whenever you go to try to unlock it, it'll get stuck on you. So, and that's where your door will not open. You'll hit unlock as many times as you want, and this little pin will never move. So what you have to do, so like right now I'm hitting the lock button. And it won't do anything. So what you're gonna have to do is fool the lock system. You come over here to the latch and you shut it. For starters, before I even do that, you have to notice that I have actually plugged both connectors back in. So as if this is mounted in the, you know, mounted in the door, the lock system doesn't know the difference. So what you have to do is get a screwdriver, whatever, fool it. And now it thinks that it's locked. So now you can actually hit lock. See what I mean? Go around to this other side. See how that little pin is where it needs to be? See, now it's moving all the way. That's the problem, is whenever you hit unlock, that little pin won't move all the way over. That's lock. That's unlock. So I'm going to hit lock. That puts it right over there. So to get this thing to work right, to get that little pin to move where you want it to go, you have to get a little grinder wheel and you have to grind out right here. You got to grind this little edge down right here, and you have to grind the bottom edge down. So it gives this little pin more room to move around. So, cause if not, it'll hang up on it. See how the little lever moves down right here? That pin, this pin right here, will hang up on this lever. So you have to grind this down. You have to grind it down quite a bit right here and right here. So you can see now, see, it goes where it needs to go. Before, what it would do, I'll just simulate it. That pin would hang down just the lever would hang down just a little bit. See, it hangs up right there. Oh, see that pin, it won't move. So that's why you have to grind that sucker down just a little bit. And then it'll go. See, every single time. I've had it this way now for, I don't know, 8 or 9 months, and it's worked flawlessly every single time. So, and that is exactly how you fix this little design flaw in this latch. So, anyway, I hope this helped. If you need to, I'll try to show how to put everything back in reverse order. If not, you can probably go and just stop the video right now. I might also add that once you unlock it, go and take your screwdriver. Hold on. Oh, sorry, not your screwdriver. I'm sorry. take the lever right here that the cable is attached to and open your latch back up, or else whenever you try to shut it, it's going to hit the striker pin and you could break the latch again. So, all right, there you go. Okay, this is where I'm going to try to show you how to put everything back together in the reverse order after you fixed the little pin situation where you grind it down. I actually just took I've got some little carbide bits that I have on a air grinder, and I just sat there, I moved the pin over to the right hand side right here, and I just ground it down, and I kept doing it until it worked right. So anyway, go ahead and unplug everything. Let's see. Yep. Then just take your little plastic cover here. Oh, something I might add is whenever you go to put the cable, if you have a new cable or anything that you're wanting to put in, or even an old one, if it's still okay, because a lot of times what'll happen is this plastic section of the cable right here will get old and brittle, and it'll break apart, and it just will not hold very good right here. So that's why I always recommend at least replacing the cable at the same time. But once you get it in there to hold it in real nice and tight, you take some pliers and you squeeze it together right here, just a little bit, to hold that cable in nice and tight. So anyway, and putting the little plastic cover back on, it's not too terrible, but it's kind of a pain in the butt with this little connector, because you do have to get stuff lined up just right. Let's see if I can remember how to do this right. Trying to feed that connector through there. See, it's this one little connector, this little one little two wire white connector. It helps if you feed that thing through there first. That's kind of the only hard part really about putting this thing back together. See, if you notice the wire loom, I don't know if you can see it or not. Let's see if I can get my light in a better spot here. The wire loom will tend to get hung up in the linkage and stuff, so you got to be able to make sure it goes out of the way. There we go. Connector's through there. Make sure cable goes in its little groove. Then snap that sucker back in. Boop. See, there it goes. Right there. Take a look up inside of here, make sure everything looks good. Yeah. Take a screwdriver, kind of push this harness back where it needs to go. Yeah, I don't think it went where it needs to be. Get that out of the way. It's up in there. Oh. Oh yeah, that looks a lot better. So, anyway, at this point, once you get it up in there, if you notice on the latch, there's a little alignment pin right here. And I don't know if you can see it or not, there's a little hole right here where that alignment pin has to go. Yeah, there it goes. All right. Yep. Little wire loom inside there looks pretty good. No problems there. Then once you do that, don't forget to put, come on now, don't forget to put your two screws back in the cover. Okay, so after you've put the two screws back in the cover, we're going to plug it in and test it real quick. Plug it back in. Also, don't forget to install the little black plug, dust cover, whatever the heck this thing is. Don't forget to put that back in. It's right there where it needs to be. All right, and like I showed you before, we're going to trick the lock to make it think that the rear hatch is closed. Okay, it is now locked. I'm going to hit unlock twice. In theory, you should be able to hit this and it'll open. So once you do that, we're going to put this back in here. Push the latch right back through the opening on the door, right here on the bottom. Don't forget to take, let's see, don't forget to take your cable and snap it back in its little holder. Perfect. And then you can also take your little electrical harness right here, this little clip that holds it in place here in the door. Be sure you put that right back in. All right, once you get your latch back in the door and the little mounting hole down here, be sure that you take the three little bolts that you took out before. Back in. Take your little cover that you previously took off. Don't forget about the two little alignment or mounting tabs right here. Just kind of slip on right there. Bam, it's on. Okay, something I want to add for you guys that have that actually have a broken handle, the easiest way to replace that thing is, if you look up inside of here, you see that is the back side of the handle. There's just a 10 millimeter nut right there. Move the other side, there's a 10 millimeter nut right there. There's the latch. It looks pretty nasty, but that's actually a spray grease that I've put on it to help it out. But anyway, you take those two nuts out, and then also the little cable right there. You have to be able to finagle the little cable end ball out of the latch, and then also where the handle snaps onto the cable. You might pinch that down just a little bit to help hold that cable just a little bit tighter. They do have a tendency to pop out. But yeah, that'll help quite a bit. Replacing these handles is pretty easy. It's almost the same instructions as before, as you know, getting the rear door panel off and the access panel and everything. And then once you get all that off, you just take the two nuts off, take that cable off, and that will come right out. That's it on that. Okay, so now it's time to put the access panel cover back in place. And sometimes whenever you first take this cover off, some of the little clips will pop out. And I have this handy dandy little tool right here. It is literally just made for popping out body panel clips and stuff. So stick it right up underneath. Comes right out. Come over to the panel. And it'll pop right in that little spot right there. And I have to do the same thing to this side panel over here, because one of the clips popped out. All right, we're gonna start popping these little panels back in here. As you can see, this one goes right here. Just gotta line up the pins, push them in. Yep, right there. Put the screws back in. Okay, now we're going to do the center panel. Okay, that should just stay in place. Now it's really just a matter of just starting putting screws back in. Yeah, that one little clip just didn't want to hold real good. Just going to put a screw right there. And now it'll hold. Stripped out. That's okay. And another stripped out. But that's all right. All right. Now we're going to put the whole panel cover back on. You kind of have to start off by hanging it off the top edge right here, and then you'll end up snapping in all the little clips. can't do this upside down. Goes. Come over here and line these up. There it is. There's that. Then you're going to want to put the little side pieces on. Let's see. Here. Just get them lined up. Just like that. There it is. And then, let's see here. This final piece right here that goes right across the top. I gotta get my light out of the way. What else? Don't forget the strap that goes. Let's see. It goes right there. Okay. All right, now we're going to test it, make sure that everything works. Lock it. Okay, it is now locked. Let's unlock it. Oh, how about that? Works like a champ. If you want to see any of the tools that I used in this, so you can kind of be prepared for yourself, it helps if you have some little needle nose pliers. I have a little quarter inch impact, but you don't need that. A little quarter inch ratchet would work just fine. A 10 millimeter socket, a couple of flashlights. That's what I have, just a little Amazon flashlight I had. Little trim clip. Popper tool, I don't know what you want to call that. Just a simple Phillips screwdriver. My needle nose pliers, the long ones, for popping the cable out of the handle. Like I said, you can have this style or the kind that curves straight down. Another flashlight I have. Just a little mini pocket screwdriver. It really helps with the little small stuff. And then just a larger flathead screwdriver. For the larger things, if you need it, you don't have to, but that's what I used. And if you have any questions about this, just ask me in the comments. All right, I hope this really helps, and hope you have a good day. Thanks. Bye.